Happening right now, an advisory panel with the Centers for Disease Control, or CDC, and Prevention now wrapping up their emergency meeting. They're looking into reports of heart inflammation following COVID-19 vaccination. For the latest details on these discussions, we turn now to Fox 59's Bianca Reyes. She joins us now in the newsroom. And Bianca, you've been sitting in on this meeting all morning and throughout the afternoon as well. So what new data do we have to support this possible adverse reaction?
Hey, good evening. This panel of experts is going over two conditions that are actually quite common in the medical world, but extremely rare following COVID-19 vaccinations. Right now, 53% of all eligible Americans are fully vaccinated. Of those millions of vaccinated Americans, there have been 323 confirmed cases of myocarditis or pericarditis. That's inflammation of the heart muscle and the lining around the heart. Now, after hours of sharing data, here's what we know. The first cases of myocarditis following vaccination were reported in Israel back in December of 2020. As far as the 323 U.S. cases, 79% of those patients have recovered. Only 9 remain in the hospital and 2 are in the intensive care unit. Now, doctors also provided insight on who is most likely to be diagnosed with myocarditis following COVID-19 vaccination and when. It's most common in men ages 16 to 24, roughly 5 days after their second dose of either Pfizer or Moderna. The most common symptoms include chest pain, shortness of breath, and heart palpitations. And in the end, experts agree the current data suggests a, quote, likely association of myocarditis with COVID-19 vaccines. But even local doctors agree the benefits of the vaccine outweigh the rare risks of myocarditis.
All that being said, we also need to remember the risk is exceedingly low. 12 in million is still very, very rare. Again, you're more likely to get struck by lightning, but more importantly, with COVID, you could get much more severe diseases.
Now, Dr. Ulletti went on to point out that the Johnson & Johnson vaccine is not included in these concerns, so he recommends that one dose to anyone that may be on the fence. Now, a representative with the FDA says following this meeting, the FDA and the CDC will work swiftly to update fact sheets given to parents and to the public so that they include these new findings and warnings. Reporting in the newsroom, I'm Bianca Reyes, Fox 59 News.